getting ready for our book giveaway project, and we're really excited about that. On the last day of school, we're going to have books out at the park and cook out food, and as the cheering kids come on over to play at the park, they're going to be able to pick out a book and also get a hot dog or a hamburger, and so we're planning for that. We're going to meet after church to just talk about a few things for those who are a part of that group. Also exciting, we're getting the diaper bank started, and we're receiving diapers this week, so that's wonderful. And we're going to be meeting after church next week for a little while for anyone who is interested in helping with that ministry. It is a special day. We have the baptism of Madison today, and the flowers on the altar were given in celebration of her baptism by her grandparents, and so it's just a very special day. Also, the choir is singing, but it's not in the bulletin, so that will happen after the children's message. We continue with the liturgy in the bulletin. Please rise. He is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Gracious God, have mercy on us.
We confess that we have turned from you and given ourselves into our sins. We are truly sorry and humbly repent. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things we have done and things we have failed to do. Turn us again to you and uphold us by your Spirit, so that we may live and serve you in newness of life, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
God, who is rich in mercy, loved us even when we were dead in sin, and made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. Almighty God, strengthen you with power through the Holy Spirit, that Christ may live in your hearts through faith. Amen. And our gathering song is number 732.
Thank you.
the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
And yeah, after you do the job, stay there. Okay. Does anybody know who Colin is?
Yes.
You know who Colin is. Take this. Can you give that to Colin, please? Because he's going to read some special words. Would, let's see, Janessa, would she take the candle off the package? There's a candle. Can you get it open? In the meantime, let's see, Weston, would you get the napkin out of that? Okay? So I need you, Colin, raise your hand. Bring that over to Colin right there.
Okay.
And can the two of you bring that over to Madison's mom and dad? Because they're going to need a box. Thank you, Weston. Okay. So I'll take that. I need, who's good at throwing things away? Could you throw this in the garbage right there? You two can go do it. If you had juggled, when the three of you carefully hold this, you would hold it too. That's going to wipe the water off our head after we have to take it there. So if you three put that there, you tell us already. Okay. So you guys do not. I need 1, 2, 3 people. So 1, 2, 3.
Thank you. Janessa.
Janessa.
Thank you.
Now the apostles and the believers who were in Judea heard that the Gentiles had also accepted the word of God. So when Peter went up to Jerusalem, the circumcised believers criticized him, saying, "Why did you go to uncircumcised men and eat with them?" Then Peter began to explain to them, step by step, saying, "I was in this city of God. Over the sand, I saw a vision. There was something like a large sheep coming down from heaven, being lowered by its four corners, and it came close to me. As I looked at it closely, I saw four-footed animals, beasts of prey, reptiles, and birds of the air. I also heard a voice saying to me, 'Get up here, kill and eat.' But I replied, 'By no means, Lord, for nothing profane or unclean has ever entered my mouth.' But a second time, the voice answered from heaven, 'What God has made clean, you must not call profane.' This happened three times. Then everything was pulled up again to heaven. At that very moment, three men sent to me from Caesarea arrived at the house where we were. The Spirit told me to go with them and not to make a distinction between them and us. These six brothers also accompanied me, and we entered the man's house. He told us how he had seen the angel standing in his house and saying, 'Send to Joppa and bring Simon, who is called Peter. He will give you a message by which you and your entire household will be saved.' And as I began to speak, the Holy Spirit fell upon them, just as it had upon us in the beginning. And I remembered the word of the Lord, how he had said, 'John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit.' If then God gave them the same gift that he gave us when we believed in the Lord Jesus Christ, who was I that I could be your God?" When they heard this, they were silent. And they praised God, saying, "Then God has given even to the Gentiles the repentance that leads to life." Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
We will read Psalm 148 responsibly. Alleluia, praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise God in the heights.
Praise the Lord, all you angels. Sing praise, all you hosts.
Praise the Lord, sun and moon. Sing praise, all you shining stars.
Praise the Lord, heaven and heavens, and the waters above the heavens.
Let them praise the name of the Lord, who commanded when they were created.
May them stand fast forever and ever. Give them a law that shall not pass away.
Praise the Lord from the earth, you see monsters in all deeps.
Fire and hail, snow and fog.
Hills, fruit trees, and all cedars.
All beasts and all cattle, creeping things and wild birds.
Sovereigns of the earth and all peoples, princes and all rulers of the world.
Now men and maidens, old and young together.
Let them praise the name of the Lord, whose name is only exalted, whose splendor is over earth and heaven.
The Lord has raised up strength for the people, and praise for all faithful servants, the children of Israel, the people who are near the Lord. Hallelujah.
Today's second reading is from Revelation, chapter 21, verses 1 through 6, and can be found on page 1134 of your pew Bible. I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them, and they will be his peoples. And God himself will be with them. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, for the first things have passed away." And the one who was seated on the throne said, "See, I am making all things new." Also he said, "Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true." Then he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give water as a gift from the spring of the water of God. Word of God, word of life."
Thanks be to God.
God will also glorify him in himself and will glorify him at once. Little children, I am with you only a little longer. You will look for me. And as I said to the Jews, so now I say to you, where I am going, you cannot come. I give you a new commandment, that you love one another, just as I have loved you. You also should love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated. So in one of the readings that Cindy read just now, he read from the book of Revelation, where the disciple John is having a vision. God is giving him a glimpse into sort of like the present and the future at the same time, but this future of how all of this will end. And it will end with death and crying and pain being no more, God wiping every tear from our eyes. And that beautiful passage starts with an interesting sentence. The one on the throne, so we imagine that's probably God in this vision, is saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals." Now, when I hear the word mortals in scripture, right now I always think of a story, something that happened in our family. Now, if there is a connection, you'll see what the connection is. But one day, it was quite a few years ago, my daughter was pretty little at this time, we discovered in our basement a tiny mouse. It was like an inch long, its eyes were still closed. The eyes were closed, it was in the middle of the cold basement floor, it seemed like it was trying to drag itself along. And I didn't know what to do, so I got a little cloth, and I picked it up, and I put it outside under a shrub. Well, my daughter kept going outside, and she kept just looking at it, and looking at it. And I mean, I knew what the fate of this mouse probably would be, and she said to me, "We have to do something. If we can do something, we have to do something." So I end up on the phone, calling Lakeland Animal Shelter, do you take mice? And they said, "We don't, but there is a place that might take that mouse. It's called Fellow Mortals." I don't know if you've heard about this place. It's in Lake Geneva. It is an animal, a wildlife rehabilitation hospital. So I called, and they took my call very seriously. I mean, very seriously. They gave me strict instructions about what to do. They said, "Yes, we'll take the mouse." They told me to put it in a bucket with a warm water bottle so it would stay warm. We drove it over there, and they took a look at it, and they said, "It probably won't make it because it's so little, but we're going to do everything we can. It needs to eat every 2 hours, and so we're going to have someone through the night feeding it through the night." I was kind of amazed at the care and love given to this tiny little mouse. At Christmas time, I got a letter from this place called Fellow Mortals, and it told me that if I wanted to know what happened to the mouse, I could give a donation of $50. I'm sorry to tell you I don't have an ending to this story. But I was astounded at the care and the attention and the exquisite compassion given to this tiny little creature whose fate was unknown, who made no difference to any humans at all, except that some humans from this organization called Fellow Mortals saw that we human beings have in common with creation mortality, need, vulnerability, and that moves them to care for God's fragile creation. And this is not a comment putting down what they do at all, the compassion that they have, the passion they have for God's creation, but it makes me think, wouldn't it be wonderful if we had a place like that for human beings, where they could call and somebody would be there, where it didn't matter what you did or what how hopeless your situation seemed or how worthwhile you seemed to anybody else, but you could call and you could receive that exquisite kind of care from others who know they're just like you. They're in the same boat as you. Well, Jesus tells us in the gospel today that people will know that we are his disciples by the love that we have for one another. I think Jesus is telling us the church is supposed to be that place. And Jesus was our fellow mortal. And he gave those words to the disciples, love one another as I have loved you, the night before his death. He had washed his disciples' feet, even Judas, who was about to leave and betray him. And he had broken the bread and passed it around and said, in this meal I will be with you. And then he said, I give you a new commandment. It's that you love one another, and that's how people will know that you're my followers. They're not going to know that you're my followers by you following all the rules perfectly. They're not going to know that you're my followers by how you look or what you wear, but how you show love to one another. And that love is really the beginning of resurrection. That love in the face of uncertainty and death and all that happens in our life, that's the promise. And I think of that beautiful hymn that we sang at the start of the service, that God was there to hear our warning cry, and God will be there with us throughout our lives until we are old. See, the home of God is among mortals, and our call is to love. To love as we have been loved. Amen.
Please rise for the hymn.
Thank you.
The congregation, you can join us with the baptismal liturgy. It is on page 227 in the front part of the hymnal. So you go to page 227. God, who is rich in mercy and love, gives us a new birth into a living hope through the sacrament of baptism. By water and the word, God delivers us from sin and death and raises us to new life in Jesus Christ. We are united with all the saints with the gift of the Holy Spirit and joined in God's mission for the life of the world. Caitlin and Mike, called by the Holy Spirit and trusting in the grace and love of God, do you desire to have Madison baptized into Christ? If so, answer, we do. And sponsors, called by the Holy Spirit, trusting in the grace and love of God, do you desire to stand with Madison if she is baptized? If so, answer, we do. And as you bring Madison to receive the gift of baptism, you are entrusted with responsibilities to live with her among God's faithful people, bring her to the Word of God and the Holy Supper, teach her the Lord's Prayer, the Creed, and the Ten Commandments, place in her hands the Holy Scriptures, and nurture her in faith and prayer so that she may learn to trust God, to proclaim Christ through word and deed, to care for others and the world God made, and to work for justice and peace. Do you promise to help her grow in the Christian faith and life? If so, answer, we do. And people of God, do you promise to support Madison and pray for her in her new life in Christ? If so, answer, we do.
We do.
I ask you to profess your faith in Jesus Christ, reject sin, and confess the faith of the church. Do you renounce the devil and all the forces that defy God? If so, answer, I renounce them. Do you renounce the powers of this world that rebel against God? I renounce them. Do you renounce the ways of sin that draw you from God? Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended to heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God the Holy Spirit?
I believe in God the Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning your Spirit moved over the waters, and by your word you created the world, calling forth life in which you took delight. Through the waters of the flood you delivered Noah and his family, and through the sea led your people Israel from slavery into freedom. At the river, your son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By the baptism of Jesus' death and the resurrection, you set us free from the power of sin and death and raise us up to live in you. Pour out your Spirit, the power of your living word, that those who are washed in the waters of baptism may be given new life. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. now and forever. Madison, God, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Holy Spirit, you give your daughters and sons new birth, cleanse us from sin and raise them to eternal life. Sustain Madison Dawn with the gift of your Holy Spirit, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever. Madison Dawn, child of God, you have been sealed with the Holy Spirit and marked at the cross of Christ forever. Amen. Welcome at the bottom of page 231. Let us welcome the newly baptized. We welcome you into the body of Christ and into the mission we share. Join us in giving thanks and praise to God and bearing God's creative and redeeming word to all the world.
We also have a quilt.
Wealth of power. God in mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Chasten to the Remain with those experiencing despair and great need. We pray for those we know who need your care, and we may be for you now. God, in your mercy, place holy love at the center of all our relationships and communities. By your love, heal us, convict us, and renew us. Bring an end to racism in our churches and communities. Let everyone know your goodness by the love we show one another. God, in your mercy, give us a place in the diverse company of your beloved saints. Teach us the value of each person's identity, and bless us as a shared identity of your children and the of Christ. God, in your mercy, in your mercy, O God, respond to these prayers, and renew us by your life-giving spirit. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
We bring the nether with signs of
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give
give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
All are welcome to receive communion. You will receive a piece of bread, and then your tray. The lighter color is grape juice, the darker color is wine. If you prefer gluten-free, just let us know, and that will be up there too, so we have that as well. When you receive your little cup, there's a spot at the end of each front pew where you can drop your empty cup. You start on this side, and then you go circle around to the back. Children that are not yet receiving communion are welcome to come forward for a blessing. and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Let me pray. We give you thanks, generous God, for this bread and cup we have tasted, the new heaven and earth, where hunger and thirst are no more. Send us from this table as witnesses to the resurrection, that through our lives all may know life in Jesus' name. Amen. And receive this blessing. God, the author of life, Christ, the living cornerstone, and the life-giving spirit of adoption, bless you now and forever. Amen. And our sending song is number 881.
Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Hallelujah.